Hi, kitty cats. Last time I talked about how we transgender women are under pressure not to pass too well if we want to remain welcome in some transgender communities. But we also face pressure from the rest of society to look better than cisgender women. What's a girl to do? Well, if it wasn't already obvious, all of us in Western society face huge pressure to live up to social ideals. Men must be alpha males with fat wallets and fast cars. Women must be bouncy blonde beauties with perfect children, a perfect marriage, and a successful career, all in the background, of course. And we transgender women and men get held to social expectations far more stringently than cisgender women and men. Why? Because Western society views us as attempting to steal an identity to which we were never entitled. The entrenched fallacy that sex is identical to gender runs very deep, and even those who believe they are tolerant, perhaps even accepting, can struggle to see transgender women and men as who we really are. I mean, heck, even other transgender women and men struggle to validate each other. Just see my last video for more information. Humans display a vast range of physical characteristics. Some men are short and stout. Some men are tall and thin. Some women have hourglass figures, and some women are pixie-like. But in the cisgender realm, every human presentation is inherently valid. Regardless of social status, profession, fashion sense, cool or nerdy, popular or unknown, every child born gets a free pass to express themselves, as long as it conforms to what a doctor guessed the child should be at birth. The nerdiest, most effeminate human guessed to be male is granted a free pass to manhood. The roughest, most masculine human guessed to be female is granted a free pass to womanhood. And true, Western society may snicker behind its hand at these people for failing to conform to social expectations, but they are not questioned for their gender. Their gender is accepted, is valid, because they do not challenge the entrenched fallacy that sex is identical to gender. But transgender men and women do challenge the entrenched fallacy that sex is identical to gender, and we face two choices, both of them difficult. Our first choice is to lean into those social expectations. Transgender men may grow beards and pump up in the gym. Transgender women may wear short skirts, lavish makeup, or adopt hairstyles seen only in anime. Both transgender men and women may turn to surgery to modify our bodies in order to conform with how society defines masculinity or femininity. And our other choice? To reject all social expectations of gender presentation and express ourselves as we see fit. To choose not to grant society power over our identities and live secure as the person we are. Of course, every human should be empowered with the freedom not to conform to social expectations. It's currently the default for cisgender people. It must become the default for transgender people as well. If another person's self-expression affects your rights to life, liberty, or their pursuit of happiness, the self-expression must be questioned for the safety of our society. But if that person's self-expression only causes you to raise your eyebrows, clutch your pearls, or utter a phrase such as, "Well, I never," keep it to yourself. Other people live in this world also. As I mentioned in my last video, being transgender is not a competition, and I'll generalize that now by saying expressing gender is not a competition. We're all taking part in the human experience, and that's hard enough as it is. We don't need to tear each other down. We need each other. So, show your support by liking this video and subscribing to my channel for identity education from a human perspective. Bye!